Begin by finding a position that feels comfortable for you. Maybe it's sitting in a chair or on a cushion. Really allow yourself to get comfortable in whatever position feels good for you. This is a form of meditation where it's okay to feel comfortable. It's okay to lie down if you like. Whatever you'd feel good with in your body. And take a moment to enjoy that comfort in your body. So notice what it actually feels like. That comfort, maybe being supported by the ground or a chair or the cushion, letting your muscles sink in. Wherever you feel that comfort in your body, take a moment to enjoy it. You can invite your body to relax, to let go of any muscular tension that might be present for you. If you find that your muscles are tight or tense anywhere in your body, maybe in your jaw or your shoulders or your arms, or your hands or your legs. Gently relax your body. If you'd like, if it feels good for you, invite a gentle, easy smile to your face. Doesn't have to be a huge grin, just a simple smile. Physical act of smiling inclines your body and your nervous system towards happiness. And enjoy this configuration of your body, being comfortable and relaxed with a gentle, easy smile on your face. These are some simple ways we can induce feeling good in our body. Take a moment to enjoy that. Without losing these qualities in your body, begin to involve your mind, specifically by reflecting on anything that gives rise to a sense of gratitude for you. Whatever you're grateful for, tell yourself about it in your mind, saying sentences like, I feel grateful for the food that I had to eat today, or I feel grateful for my friends and loved ones. Whatever you're grateful for, tell yourself about that in your mind. Be sure that you can hear these phrases in your mind. Whatever it is that you're grateful for, tell yourself about it. Whatever extent you feel this gratitude in your body, that these sentences give rise to a felt sense of gratitude, perhaps in your face or your chest. Notice that and really enjoy it. Those feelings may or may not arise, but if they do, really savor them. So much of this practice is about taking the time to really enjoy the positive experiences that come to us in our life. Actually enjoying them and delighting in them. Very good. Now, bring to mind someone who's relatively easy for you to feel love for. You're easy to love, person or animal. This could be a close friend or family member, perhaps a pet or a small child. It could even be imaginary. You could imagine a dog or a cat or a panda bear, or anyone you like, really. Consider who that might be for you and bring them to mind, visualizing them in your mind's eye. Visualize them being happy, perhaps smiling or laughing or playing or recalling a happy memory that you shared with them. And use that visualization as a way to cultivate love for them. The desire that they might be happy. Again, to whatever extent you feel this love in your body as you visualize them being happy, that you can feel love for them. Delight in that. Savor that love. Allow yourself to really enjoy it. Whatever extent you've cultivated this love, that you can feel it in your body, feel free to maintain that even as we transition into the main technique. There's no need to set that love aside. It can continue to grow. Begin to visualize yourself as the stars. You are the stars and the sky and the galaxy and the universe. See yourself out there in the vast darkness as a being of light and love. That you are shining light and shining love out for all to see, radiating it outwards. Visualize yourself in this way, using your mental imagination. This love and light that you are radiating outwards is directed towards all beings in every direction. See this light and this love filling the universe. And because this light and this love is filling the entire universe, it's like a blanket that folds everyone into its love and its warmth. If there are any beings that you might like to send love to, specific beings who need your love, visualize your light and your love reaching them being touched by it. And again, to whatever extent you feel this love in your body, in your heart, let that color your experience, merging with your imagination and your visualization of yourself as the stars and the light and the love radiating outwards. It's almost like you're cultivating a sense of synesthesia, where what's visual and what's felt in your body blur together. There's just love. Very good. This love that we've cultivated, it naturally wishes to manifest as kindness, as actions in the world, in our lives. Take a moment to consider if there are any acts of kindness that you might like to set the intention to do in the near future as a way to manifest this love. And as you're ready, at your own pace, you can come out of the meditation.